You got slippery slope, soap on the couch in the building.
Okay, but the slippery,
podcasters. Ooh. Two. On the same channel.
On the same channel. I like that. Ambitious. Coach, like, how did it start? What is your motivation? How do you keep your drive all the time? Like, tell us about that.
Okay, so Soap on the Couch started, well, the first time I had a thought about Soap on the Couch was about 2 years ago. I was in a store with my friends at the time, and I was like, yo, I need to do something. Like, I'm in school for journalism, but I feel like I'm not really applying myself in journalism. Like, I'm just in school doing it. So, I was like, how about I do a YouTube channel? And they were like, that'd be cool. What'd you name it? I was like, Soap on the Couch. I don't know, Soap on the Couch. And it just stuck. So I'm like, yeah, let's do that. Like, let's start a YouTube channel. So I got a cameraman. I did one episode. I think we recorded for like 3 hours.
Oh, wow.
Me and this girl. I just kept asking her questions. And I had like 3 hours worth of material. And our hard drive, when the hard drive on the computer crashed.
Ooh.
So like, we couldn't, it was something like, we couldn't formulate it properly into Premiere or one of those like movie editing things. Mm-hmm. We couldn't formulate it right. And we just had a lot of issues with it. So I lost 3 hours worth of interviewing like material. So I was like, man, like fuck this YouTube shit. Like, right. I gotta figure something else out. And so in February, I was like, all right, I'm gonna do a podcast. Like, I started listening to like the Reed, Bodega Boys, like all these like podcasters. And I was like, let me do it. Like, I don't think nobody in Philly has one. So let me, you know, be kind of the first like podcast to like, you know, make a stamp on the city. And so February came, I still wasn't doing it. Then I finally, like, in the summer was like, you know, like, I really gotta buckle down, get this shit done. So sent them interview, those invitations out, got people to be on the podcast, and that's how we're here now.
That's what's up. So tell us about the name Soap on the Couch. Like, is it a thing where you was just in the house, you was like, damn, like, I dropped the soap on the couch. And then like, I dropped the soap on the couch, like.
Okay, so I used to have a crush on Earl Sweatshirt.
Oh, everybody did. I feel like everybody had a crush on him.
Earl Sweatshirt is like, used to be best. So his name was Soap on the Lawn.
Okay.
The Tumblr.
Okay.
And I'm like, I like that soap idea, because soap goes along with the idea of fresh, clean, new.
Okay.
So like, and it was supposed to be a YouTube series, so they were supposed to be on the couch with me.
Absolutely. Okay.
So it's supposed to be like fresh new artists being on the couch. So on the couch.
Okay.
So then it was like, alright, like, even though I'm not having the couch no more implemented because I'm not doing the YouTube video, I was like, I'm still gonna keep the name because overall it's a dope name.
Like, yeah, I'm about to say it's doing like, nice.
When people was like, when I say the name of the company, they like, soap on the couch. So it's like, all right, like, even though I'm not doing the YouTube videos no more, I'm still going to be soap on the couch, because that's, you know, I like it, and I can work a lot with it, like, design-wise and like company-wise, I can do a lot with the idea of soap in a couch, like, you know, I can do endless like graphics and things of that nature. So
that's dope. I like
the name. So the name has a lot of like usefulness to it.
You know, we work together a lot. You know, I always see you grinding, always see you, you know, doing the journalism thing.
MHQ.
You know, MHQ, you know. But like, so like, when you invite people to your, you know, your platform, like, how do you go about it? What kind of people are you looking for?
So I have a special way that I do invitations to be on Soap on the Couch. I'm not going to say, because this is like my way that I really like love it.
Right.
And so I like, it's just one of those things, like, if you get an invitation from Soap on the Couch, you know it's an invitation from Soap on the Couch, because it's different.
Mm-hmm.
So, I send out those invitations, and this invitation is basically, like, not to give too much away, it's like me just kind of, like, running, like, what exactly we aim to, like, achieve within our interview with you.
Right.
Just to kind of give you a taste of what to do, like, I mean, what we'll be doing with you, but not like too much, because also I don't like to, I don't, when I say I don't like to pr- prep. I mean, I don't like to do pre-questions, but I like read your work and I like listen to your music. Right. I kind of like follow your social medias and see like what you're about as a person a little bit. And then I invite you and then I just kind of get a feel of what just like vibe out when we do an interview. Like, I don't like pre-questions only because if you say something interesting during like the interview, I don't want to try to like nail, trying to work my way back to a question that I feel like I'm supposed to be asking.
Right.
Instead of just going in the moment and just seeing where the conversation takes us.
Okay.
So that's one thing. Everything's like in the nail.
Okay.
And it's all like just, it's really just a conversation between like friends. That's the best way I try to like describe it.
So it's like authentic, like
it's authentic.
Yeah,
like
there you go. Authentic.
It's just us talking, having a conversation. And especially because like the first season was all women artists that I was doing.
Okay.
It felt like I was talking to my friends, and a lot of them girls I'd never met before. Like, I knew them from social media presence, but like, I'd never had like a real conversation with them. So it was like real nice to get to like, you know, get to know them true selves without like, you know, trying to keep them to a script or something of that nature.
Right.
Like, we sat down, we talked, and you know,
it was hot.
Like every interview was a great interview that I've had.
Want to just be, you know, stay on social media? Like, tell us about their process.
So currently I have a new thing. I'm gonna do a Soap on the Couch in a little bit. I'm not sure when I'm gonna do it, but I definitely want to reach out to more artists of different mediums a little bit. So like, Soap on the Couch is primarily music.
Right.
You know, I'm usually having like singers, rappers coming. I did a poet for the last episode of the first season. So I've been doing a lot of people who do oral work.
Okay.
So I want to like learn in a little bit more about like artists, like actual, like, you know, photographers, graphic designers, things of that nature. So I'm going to try to like touch bases with them a little bit more in the nearby future and just try to get different perspectives on how people want to, you know, start communication with their artwork and, you know, give people platforms. Because luckily I was able to kind of create my own platform, and I feel like everybody is creating their own platform in different ways, but I would love to expand my platform by giving others platforms as well.
I like
and
it.
Just make sure, like, for us to be Philly Support Philly, you know, I feel
let's
like
talk about it.
I definitely need to make sure that I'm reaching out to everybody in different aspects and spectrums to make sure that all of us are basically eating in some way or another. So
listen, because if you eat, we all eat,
right.
Sis.
You're not on no fucking diet, bro.
Okay.
If I got bread, you got bread too. Like, open bread.
Open that box. What we got? We got we got the fucking full course out here.
I can't support this. I don't eat meat.
Here you go.
I like corn.
Alhamdulillah, sis. Look
at myself.
Okay. So listen, lastly, you know, because I'm in the same field, right? And I always admire a woman, like, because I want to know about like how you tell yourself, this is for me, I'm going to keep going regardless of, you know, what everybody else is doing. So like, I want to know your biggest advice to other women.
Wow.
You know.
Wow.
You know, especially me, because, you know, I admire you. You're my guy. Like.
Authenticity is definitely a major characteristic to have. Don't do anything that you're not comfortable like doing. Like talking about subject matters, don't fit in boxes that aren't boxes that you're supposed to fit into, because you're not a square, you're a human. So, you know, you're not designed to be in a certain mold. I feel like it's great to definitely make sure you're speaking to as many people as possible and get as many perspectives on different things. Connecting is definitely major, but also make sure you're connecting with people who aren't trying to exploit you of your talents. So just, you know, be subjective about who you're letting in your space, especially as women. You have to be careful about who you're letting in your spaces, because a lot of times people are like trying to, you know, use your niceness to their advantage, and, you know, things of that nature. Like, they try to exploit you or objectify you and things of that nature. So when it comes to a company or your brand, make sure your brand and your company represents what you are about as a person, and not try to conform to what other people want you to be.
Right. Okay, I like that. You know, so again, like, tell the people who you are. You know, a little salt. Tell them about the. So again, tell them who you are. Like, you
I'm
are
Sabreen. Stubborn. I'm Soap on the Couch.
Soap on the Couch. Where can they follow you? Where can they follow this handsome devil? Look at you. Where can they follow? The co-host of Soap. Okay. Because he had me tight on Twitter. Oh, that is him. With all them damn caps. Being a little smut.
My man just trying to eat his platter. So you go follow us.
You know, the crew.
Soap on the Couch.
The guys.
Tumblr. We have a Tumblr. We have a Twitter. We have an Instagram. All Soap on the Couch. You can follow him on his Twitter at Little Slut. You can follow me on Twitter at Sabreen, and that's SVVREE.
Ooh, I like that. The SV.
Season 2 of Soap on the Couch is coming very soon.
Listen, she says seasons like a scandal. Yep. Ooh,
bitch, I'm Shonda Rhimes.
Okay.
I'm Shonda Rhimes of SoundCloud.
Cause it's handled. Oh.
Ooh, damn, that's like being my body.
Cause it's handled. Sis, you better handle.
And that's the game.